Welcome back to Fallout 4. We've just arrived at Vault 81. Let's get talking to everybody inside of here and see if there's anything we can do to help them. There's got to be at least a couple quests in here, and I think there's even a barbershop as well.
Thank God Ashes is back. Aaron is crazy about that cat.
Do you wear your vault suit in the Commonwealth, or just when you visit us?
Actually, I do wear it in the Commonwealth. I think it's pretty stylish.
Katie Pinn is the teacher here in 81. You should stop by her class. She's big on learning from outsiders.
Okay, go speak with her. So before I go down, let's go see what's over here.
Hope you're not making any trouble.
Hi.
Now that you made it in, we'll be keeping an eye on you. So do us all a favor and behave yourself.
I'm having to constantly suppress my urge to just loot everything, but it's stealing. It's stealing. I can't do it. I mean, I could try, but that's not my kind of character.
Hi, how
are
you?
I'm not a thief. I'm doing pretty well, thanks. You know what? It's considered stealing to actually take it into my inventory, but is it considered stealing to move it? No, it's not! Ha! So
don't
I can play with her junk.
Trouble in 81.
I can play with her junk, I just can't take it. Come on, dog meat.
Hey, over here.
Dog meat?
Move here.
There you go. Oh, right, dog meat disappears. And then phases back in right about now. Yeah, given how long it takes this elevator to go all the way down to the rest of the vault, the main vault must be really deep in the ground. Yeah, I mean, it's so deep underground that I lost the settlement recruitment signal. So it's seriously deep. Okay, let's go from the top down, I guess. That must be the overseer's office over there. Yep, that's the overseer's office. Look at how patriotic it is. It's an American flag there, and I think that's like a seat right there. That seems to be covered in the American flag, too. Anyway.
Wow, you're from one of the other vaults. At least some of them survived.
Hey.
Yes?
She's looking pretty bad in there.
Oh, Calvin,
need
I think...
check the water pumps again. The water smells funny.
Maybe I can help with that. And I think that guy's the guy that someone said wanted tools.
Our Commonwealth guest, welcome to the depot. And pardon the clutter, I don't get much time to tidy up these days.
Oh, look at that. Is it like Halloween right now or something? Candy all over the place. Halloween pumpkins.
Must be keeping busy then. At least business is good.
Too good these days. When you're dealing with items that are all over 200 years old, work just accumulates like crazy. Some days it's all I can do to keep my head above water. But you probably don't want to hear about all that. Let me know if you want to take a look.
Apparently she's so busy she hasn't even had time to take a shower. Her face is just completely smudged and covered in dirt. What kind of hours are they forcing these people to put in?
Do you run this place by yourself?
Well, there's my husband, Halt, but once you need him, he's nowhere to be found. I swear the cat is more help than he is.
Why do you say that?
I really shouldn't get into it.
Oh, you really should. It's all right. You can tell me.
It's all right. You can tell me.
Halt's just changed. He's never around, always claiming he has some errands to run. Back when we first met, he seemed devoted till the end. He actually taught me everything I know when it comes to fixing things. He'd spend every minute he could with me, and of course Aaron after we had her. Now, it's like we don't exist, and every conversation we have is a fight.
Have you talked to him about it?
I've tried, but he won't listen to me. He's always saying he doesn't have time.
Sounds like an asshole.
Sounds like an asshole to me.
Most days. If I didn't know the man he used to be, the man I fell in love with, I'd agree. 100%. But enough about him. Let me know if I can help you with anything here at the depot. I need to get back to work.
I wonder if I can find him and speak with him. Maybe I can do something to help their marriage.
What do you sell?
Odds and ends. A bit of everything, I suppose. But no weapons. Only security guards carry weapons around here.
I might be interested in buying or selling.
Great. I have all sorts of odds and ends.
See if she's got anything big. Anything I really gotta have? Probably not. Increases wearer's movement speed by 10%. A flat-out 10% movement speed increase. That's nice. What's my current right leg? Reduces damage from super mutants by 15%. Okay, that's definitely not amazing. Protection is 8, 13, 10. This one is 11, 11, 0. It's also really expensive. That would cost me like almost all of my caps. It's not worth that much. Nah, 10% movement speed's not worth that much. Whoa. Whoa. Overseer's Guardian. Shoots an additional projectile. That is a sniper rifle and a beautiful one. Shoots 45 rounds. The damage is really weak though, but I could maybe change that. Possibly. Regardless though, it costs like 3 times the amount of caps that I currently have, so that's not going to happen for a long time. But it could be worth coming back for that. 10% reduction in action points cost in VATS. Meh. Reduces damage while standing and not moving by 15%. Meh. That one's 14,000? Yeah. Not gonna happen. Okay, do you have any, what's it called? The stuff for the cryolator. I kinda forgot what it was called. Cryo something? Nah, it doesn't seem like she has it. Alright, I'm good. See, I want to keep this place in mind. If I ever get a lot of money, it might be worth coming back here, buying that weapon, and seeing if I can upgrade it so that it's as good or better than my current sniper. I don't know, the special stat for it is the same as this rifle, where it shoots 2 projectiles, so maybe it would just end up being basically the same thing.
Hybridization.
That's worth checking,
though. It's got to be a flaw in the hybridization.
Yeah?
Alright, I heard you want tools.
Hey, Calvin.
Sorry, new gal. Not a lot of time to talk right now.
I'll be quick. I promise.
Ha! We'll see about that. What can I do you for?
So there's a lot of upkeep going on right now?
Hell, you could say that again. Old 81 here, she's a straight-up wreck. Pretty solid for a while, easy enough to keep up with her needs, but in the last few years or so, damn, she got feisty. Been going through tools like they were going out of style, so if you got any, I'd be more than happy to take them off your hands.
How much are you paying?
I'd say 15 caps per tool. Overseer won't let me go higher, but I'll take as many as you can grab.
Sure, you got yourself a deal.
Stupendous! One less thing to bug the Overseer about. Anyway, here I am running my mouth when there's work to do. Sorry I can't talk longer, stranger. But mind the maintenance. Shouldn't get in your way, at least.
How many tools do I have right now? Oh yeah, look at this. There's like work order tags or something like that. Or danger tags, whatever those are, all over the place. Oh, this music's cool.
Hey there, you got some tools for me today?
I don't think I've heard the soundtrack before. This song from the soundtrack. Okay, yeah, here you go. Really? I've got tools on me? Should I give them up? I mean, I guess the tools are probably just going to be ground down into probably just steel, I would guess. And I have plenty of steel, so I guess you can take all of them?
Yeah, here you go.
Perfect. Keep an eye out. We can always use more.
All I had was a wrench. All right, well, maybe I should go back to my, back to Sanctuary and see how many wrenches we have. Are you okay, Dogmeat?
Hey. Here. Head over there.
Meh, you'll figure it out. Poor Dogmeat. Oh, there you go.
What I wouldn't give for some brand spanking new genuine Vault-Tec parts right now.
Hey.
Don't try anything.
Okay, all of security seems to be made up of assholes. Overseer's office. Probably locked, I'm guessing. Oh no. The Overseer isn't here. This place looks really pretty. If nobody sees me steal anything, does it actually have any negative effect? I don't intend to try it unless I find something, like, absolutely amazing. I mean, really, the only thing I'd steal, honestly, is just information. I'm not gonna steal just goods. But, you know, if there's maybe some incriminating evidence against the Overseer. Perhaps, perhaps.
I'll be damned if that whole duct isn't gonna need replacing.
There's probably some evidence on the computer, but I don't have advanced skill.
Can't break the code.
If I put 1 point into hacking, would I be able to do advanced? Yeah. Wow, if I put 1 point into this, I could hack it. No. I don't want to be a hacker. I just don't. Yeah, she lives in comfort. This gets her own big room, her own shower, beautiful wood paneling.
So you're the reason that patrols are doubled today.
Just because of me? Really?
Yes.
You look angry.
Excuse me.
You should stop by and see Horatio while you're here. Can't imagine you come across many barbers in the Commonwealth.
Just keeps, like, spinning around. What are you doing? What are you doing? I think that's it for the top floor. Yeah.
Get to.
I heard we had a traitor in today.
You may wear a vault suit, but we're still watching you.
Hey there.
You got guts wearing that pit boy in the Commonwealth. I can't believe someone hasn't tried to steal it yet.
Maybe they have. I don't know. Hundreds of raiders have tried to kill me. Oh, they've got some farming going on in here.
This strain is doing quite well.
Then I can harvest it all and it's not considered stealing.
Strong cellular plant structure.
All right, I'll take it all.
I'll have to see how it holds up to exposure. Ah, you'll do perfectly. I'm in need of a willing test subject to try this new strain of fruit I've created.
Really? Special fruit? I'd love to try it. I just hope it doesn't turn into something nasty that starts to attack me like in Fallout 1 and 2.
Why?
It's a new strain of mute fruit that I just developed. It should be nutritious and remove radiation poisoning.
Ooh.
But I need a test subject to try it.
So could that be a new healing item? I could just replace all of my crops with just that.
Sure. I like fruit.
Excellent. Just tell me how it tastes and how it makes you feel. Now, where did I put that Geiger counter?
Fresh mute fruit.
Damn it. Just holding that wrench.
I want to go plant that right now, but I'd have to go back all the way back up. Nah, I guess I'll have to wait
seeds.
Till later.
I'll need more seeds.
And this is the barber, and look! Look at the painting! Oh.
Thanks, Horatio. I love it. I didn't think I'd ever make it in with the hours I've been working.
But you did, and now you look completely refreshed. Just remember, a couple months and you come back and see me again. Off with you. get some rest.
No promises there, but I'll try.
I was hoping you'd stop by. Now I know from experience that Commonwealth shows no mercy when it comes to hair. So, how about a trim?
You've got very cool hair yourself. Although, to be honest, my hair is actually kind of beautiful. Can't really see it that well with a mining cap on. But,
You've been outside of the vault?
Quincy, born and raised. My mother, may she rest in peace. She was a doctor. Imagine her surprise when she learned I'd rather cut hair than stitch people up. But enough about me. How about that hair of yours?
Did you say you were from Quincy?
Sure did. Looks like I was one of the lucky ones, too. Last I heard, gunners had taken her over.
Heard any good rumors?
They say Holt is running around on his wife. Apparently, he and Tina DeLuca are secretly getting together. But never mind about them. Your hair is a disaster. You have to let me fix it.
Okay, I totally need to get involved in that relationship between those two people, the one that's falling apart. Oh yes, I want to meddle around in their affairs.
Any news going around?
Did you know that Bobby DeLuca was a jet junkie? He needs to quit before someone gets hurt, himself included, working in maintenance, high all the time. It's a good thing old Rusty does most of the work.
Any news going around?
Not much of late, but I'll keep my ears open for you. Sure you don't want me to do something with your hair?
Okay.
Sure.
All right, let's see what the Commonwealth has to work with. Just have a seat.
Okay, I really do like my hair, though. Honestly, I don't know if I want to change it, but I'll see if there's something I want to change it to. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay, I went from the Sophisticate, which is what I had before. This one. That's what I had before, and I switched to No Nonsense. Yeah, I like it.
Whatever you want, forget it. I can't be bothered with it right now.
Oh, Holt! That's the guy I need to talk with to meddle in their relationship. Alright. Alright, buddy, let's have a chat,
Hey, Holt.
So, you're the new gal. I heard we let someone into the vault. How long do you plan on sticking around?
You know, as long as it takes to find out why you're being such an asshole.
Long enough to have a good look around.
Well, hopefully that means not long. We can take care of ourselves here in 81. We don't need to be letting in every stray traveler that comes our way.
I don't plan on staying. Calm down. Dogmeat. Bite his ankle.
Hello, Holt.
If you need something, ask Alexis. I can't make heads or tails of her story.
Huh. I can't talk to him? That is the guy that's with... Honestly, I don't remember her name.
Some color today, or a new cut?
No, I'm good. Yeah, that is the guy that's with the shopkeeper up there, right? I don't actually remember her name. What is your name, ma'am?
Need to check the water pumps again. The water smells funny.
Alexis, yeah, Alexis Combs.
Last time I let Ash just get away from me.
Yep, good old 81. She's going to hell.
Kitty cat.
Bet you wish he took the tour now.
Right, you're the owner, Aaron Combs. So you're the daughter of these two people. Kitty cat. Anni says hi. Meow. You creepy robo kitty.
Wish my mom and dad wouldn't fight so much.
Maybe I should interview Aaron. Maybe she can tell me more about what's happening with the parents.
It's got to be a flaw.
Well, hello.
Talk to my mom if you want something fixed.
No, I want to talk to you.
I'm so excited Ashes is back. But he acts like nothing happened.
That's because he has no soul. He's not a real cat.
Someday, I'm going to check out the Commonwealth. If my grandma lets me.
I hope you don't have anything
that
needs fixing.
I'm so happy Ashes is back.
I really don't feel like
working. I was so scared.
Look at that thing. Look at that thing. Blank, dead stare. That is such a weird cat.
I can't wait till I don't have to go to school anymore.
Another lamp. What the hell? hell do these people do to them that they keep breaking?
Hi, Austin.
Gran says I'm a bottomless pit when it comes to food.
Okay, thank you for the information. I'm going downstairs now.
For an outsider, you look like you fit right in.
Alright, that's Horatio's place. That's the seeds over there. That's residential. We'll go there in just a little bit.
Do you wear your vault suit in the Commonwealth, or just when you visit us?
Lavatory. Oh, wow. So this is like the one public bathroom for everybody? Pizza, pies today. Burgers.
I heard Alexis promised one to Aaron.
Are you hungry, dog meat?
Hold. Let's go. Marcus William. Come on.
Don't you go on thinking you're so clever. Those pies are going to be for Calvin and his crew. Lord knows they could use a treat right now.
Hey, you tried telling that to Aaron and breaking a little girl's heart. I didn't realize my wife was so cold-blooded.
Mark, I swear, over 40 years of marriage, you need to count your blessings you're still alive.
I demand service. Wow, that was a really, really quiet yellow trim plate.
You must be that new traveler Gwen let in. It's always nice to see a new face around here.
Nice place you have here.
Why, thank you. Mark and I try to keep her tidy. The Sunshine Diner, we call her. If you need any food for the road or just feeling hungry, you let me know. Our menu isn't quite as exotic as the Commonwealth, but it'll do in a pinch.
Do you run this place by yourself?
Heavens no, I'd be a wreck. My husband, Mark, he helps me, though mostly with the tasting.
Is it hard work feeding everyone here?
It used to be easier. Back when I was young, we had more supplies than we could count. Why, my mother taught me some recipes that had ingredients that... Well, I doubt you could find them anywhere anymore. Since we started trading, we manage well enough, but... The variety? Let's just say it's more than a bit lacking.
I just thought... Do eggs even exist in the wasteland? I don't think I've ever seen any chickens or any eggs. Trying to bake without eggs is really difficult. Eggs are like one of the almost universal baking ingredients. It's just, they're so useful.
Cat got your tongue, dear?
No, the cat's back there, somewhere upstairs.
Have you ever thought about leaving the vault?
Never. Can you imagine? Born and raised right here in Vault 81. It was easier back then, you know. Supplies were high, and the dangers outside were both severe and unknown. Poor Gwen didn't know what she was getting into when she accepted the role of overseer.
How is Gwen doing as the overseer?
It weighs on her, I can tell. We need help from the Commonwealth, but a few people, they don't care for it. Not to mention the state of the vault. Upkeep's got people working round the clock these days. Even me. If people are going to be up all night working, they'll need a good meal to keep them going.
Let's see what you got.
Something's bound to sound good.
Probably nothing worth buying since I've got so much food, but let's just check. Yeah, nothing. Nothing I want. Nothing I don't already have.
Yeah?
Seeds. I need more seeds.
Okay, so I still need to go to residential. Been there. I think residential's the only place left. Yeah.
Watch yourself.
I heard we had a trader in today.
That'd be me. Oh, I thought maybe I could go down here. Look like this place is blocked off. Look at these weak warning post sign things. Not doing a good job of keeping people out. Alright, start upstairs here. That's classroom. Oh my god, this place is so big. Alright, let's go in the classroom first. I was supposed to speak to the teacher, but I guess class is out for now. Oh, shit! I just stole the globe. I didn't mean to. I tried to pick it up. I didn't try to take it. Oh my god. I'm so sorry. There we go. Yeah, perfect. Close the door. We were never here. Don't worry, Dogmeat will catch up. Dogmeat can phase, don't forget. See? Already caught up. Reactor. Old Rusty.
Please direct any maintenance requests to Mr. DeLuca. They will be handled in the order they were received.
So you are programmed for vault maintenance?
An astute observation. I assist Mr. DeLuca with reactor maintenance, tending to the heart of the vault. He prefers to supervise while giving me the privilege of fulfilling the tasks.
The privilege.
Does he help out with any of the work?
If memory serves, the last bit of work he performed was when Mr. Whittaker forced him to clean up the supply room. He was also quite vocal about his distaste for the job.
Someone isn't doing his fair share of work.
Hi, old Rusty?
Pardon me.
Hey, outsider. Do me a favor. If my good-for-nothing brother asks you for Jet, tell him to buzz off.
Ah, right, so it's her brother. He's the one addicted to Jet. And hold on a second.
Hey, remember what I said.
There we go.
Hi, Tina.
Hey, outsider.
You lost?
Do me a favor.
No trading going on down here.
If my good-for-nothing brother asks you for Jet,
my hands
tell him to buzz off.
Her eyeshadow looks really cool. I wonder if you can go to someone who can change your makeup. Because the haircutter, Horatio, he could only change my hair. Just the style and the color, but I wasn't able to change the rest of my face. I'd like to take
talk
a look
much?
At the makeup options again.
God, you are so awkward.
Oh my god. Fine, Tina, I'll talk.
Alright.
Look, he's a junkie, but he's getting careless. If he gets caught, we're both in trouble. And as much as I'd like to leave this canned paradise, that's not how I want to go.
If he's addicted, you should try to help him get clean.
I don't think I haven't tried. I locked him in his room for a week. It wasn't 2 days before he was using again. Now I admit, I've got my own share of the blame here. Bobby gets his chems from me, and I keep him on a short leash. But not anymore. I'm cutting off his useless ass.
She sounds so familiar, her voice actor. I swear I've heard her before. I don't know if it's I've heard her in this game before, or just in a different game, or something else entirely. She sounds so familiar.
Well? Why would you feed his habit?
He's my brother, and he's overworked. I give him a little Jet, and he perks
Wait
up.
A minute!
He seems happy, I feel better, done. Now that it's getting out of control, it's another story. He wants to put me at risk, he gets cut off.
That's Chloe. From Life is Strange, isn't it? Isn't that the voice actor who did Chloe from Life is Strange? I have to confirm this right now. I'm gonna alt-tab out and Google this, and I'll be right back. Yeah, it's the voice actor who did Chloe in Life is Strange, Ashley Birch. Huh. Apparently, she also voice acted a couple other characters in Fallout 4 as well. Two more.
Talk much?
God, you are so awkward.
I know, I'm hella awkward, right, Chloe?
Good. That's the first step to helping your brother.
Should have done it a long time ago. But things ain't easy around here.
I wonder if I can get a dick doll, which will completely remove addiction from somebody and give it to her brother. I mean, that should work. Maybe they don't even know about Adictol's existence since, well, I guess they've never left
fix
the vault.
Fix this, fix that. Never ends. Good thing we have old Rusty.
Hey,
nothing would
the
ever
outsider.
Get done here.
You lost? No trading going on down here.
I'm not lost.
Oh, well, welcome to the generator room, I guess. Oh, and hey, if you got any jet on you, I may be willing to take it off your hands. Say, 75 caps?
Yeah, no.
I'm not a dealer. I don't sell drugs.
Hey, forget I asked. Seriously. And if you could keep this little conversation under wraps, I'd appreciate it. Just don't let Tina know. She'd be all over my ass.
Tired of working. Tired of this vault.
Bobby!
Sick of working. Is this day almost over?
Well, there's no option to say, like, there's no quest to, like, get him a dick doll or something like that, but I wonder if I did get it and brought it back to him, if there'd be an option to give it to him? I really want to try it, because it makes sense. It really makes sense. Alright, anything more to say to you, Tina?
This vault would fall apart.
Hey, Tina.
Don't forget what I said. If he gets me in trouble, he'll never hear the end of it.
Yep, I got you. What's down here? Ooh. Old Overseer's Terminal. You need to be a master of unlocking to unlock it. Technician's note. Nobody can get into Overseer Olivet's terminal. The password might be corrupted. I can't make sense of this thing, and I finally convinced the Overseer to let it go and allow me to set up a new terminal. Olivet probably was hardly even using the thing anymore. I doubt there's anything important on it. Yeah, so it seems like there's just no way to get inside of this without being a master at hacking, since even if I could find the password somewhere, it wouldn't matter because the password's corrupted, right? Yeah, I feel like there's a storyline here, something about the old Overseer and the new Overseer, and maybe like a questline there that I can do or something, but since I can't get into either of the terminals, I don't think I can do anything with that. What a shame. Alright, explore the rest of this place. So that's where I came from. I just went there and the classroom, so I can go down or over. Let's go over first and then down. Austin, this is where you sleep. Aw, your precious alarm clock. I bet you need this so you can get up in the morning for school, right? Whoops. Oh, what a shame. Alexis. Oh, where's the cat? Oh my god! The cat sleeps! The cat sleeps when she sleeps. Oh my god. That cat is just so creepy. Look at it. It's like sleeping with its eyes open. What is wrong with you, cat? It can't even blink, can it? It doesn't even have eyelids. There is something very, very wrong with that cat. Giddy-up Buttercup! I've been finding parts of Giddy-up Buttercup. Heads and legs and stuff. I wonder if I can actually assemble it once I have all the parts. Oh my god, I just stole it. I tried to pick it up, but it didn't let me because it was too heavy. But then once I finished pressing E, it just stole it. Oh my god, I just stole a children's toy. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm so sorry. Okay. It's fine. I can't pick it up and I can't move it because it's too heavy. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. No! Gee! I tried to pick that up too and I stole it! Oh, fuck me! Just run, dog meat. Just run. Actually, no. You know what? She stole it. Yeah. even though it came from her own table. So she couldn't steal it because it was already hers, but... anyway. Why is there corn on top of the toilet? Who's gonna eat toilet corn?
Dr. Forsythe is asking to see you. We have a moment.
Ooh. Good.
If you need a doctor, Forsythe and Rachel are down in the medical center. They can patch you up.
Sounds like Forsythe might have a quest for me.
Hi, how are you?
All right, let's go down.
Careful, outsider.
Keep walking, outsider. Just because you wear a vault suit doesn't mean you're one of us.
Holt?
You're still here?
Mm-hmm.
Your Pip-Boy ever act up on you? Mine's been glitchy lately.
Well, there was one time just like an hour ago when it just completely disappeared and I couldn't see it anymore. That was kind of weird.
Hey there.
Oh, you're that new traveler. You must have had so many adventures out in the Commonwealth.
Oh my god, I love your hair. Maybe I should get that haircut. Wait, hold on a second.
Every waking moment is an adventure out there.
Oh my, I knew it. My kids would love to hear some of them. Would you be willing to talk to my class?
Sure. Okay, so she's the teacher.
I'd be glad to talk to him.
Marvelous. Stop by whenever class is in session. I'll just stop what I'm doing and turn the class over to you.
Sounds great. Short stories. Oh, that should be fun.
I heard we had a trader in today.
Another new face in the vault, eh? What is it we're needing now, Missy?
I love option number four.
I'm afraid that information's classified, sir. If I told you, I'd have to kill you.
Gwenny let in a good one. That sense of humor is just what this vault needs. The people here, they're a bit overworked these days. Some blame the overseer. But it ain't Gwenny's fault. Poor girl. Just landed the right position at the wrong time.
Yeah, I can't shake the feeling that there is something wrong with the overseer, with Gwen.
What's going on? Why are people so overworked?
Well, you live in the same place for 200 years. Time just takes its toll. Until the overseer opened the vault to the traitors, we were just slapping on one band-aid after the next. Now we're just scrambling to keep old 81 together.
It's not easy being a leader.
Truer words were never spoke. And I wouldn't want her job in a million years. Well, I best be getting back to it. Don't want the old lady on me again. 62 years old and still fiery as ever.
I like that guy. I just came from there, so yeah, this way. Clinic. Forsythe and Rachel,
welcome.
Was her name? Should be in here.
Welcome. I hope I'm not being presumptuous, but I'd like to ask you a favor. Would you mind donating some medical samples? Even just a blood sample?
Yeah, try to argue to get some money out of it. Nah, I'll do it for free. For science. But why?
Why do you need medical samples?
It's for my research. The people of Vault 81 have been genetically isolated from the Commonwealth for many generations. I'm trying to determine what the genetic variation is between the two populations.
Sure. You can have some blood.
Excellent. Just have a seat, and I'll draw some blood.
Okay, as long as you don't show me the needle or the blood or anything like that, I'll be good. I don't want to pass out.
Sit there. This'll only take a sec.
Okay. Please don't have an actual needle. Oh, God. All right, I'm just gonna look at the ceiling,
there.
Yep.
Hardly hurt a bit, eh? Thank you. This will be a great help.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
mm-hmm.
I need to get these prepared immediately.
Mm-hmm. Okay. They've just got a couple unrefrigerated blood packs. Don't you need to refrigerate blood? That seems not good. You must be Rachel?
You're that wanderer from the Commonwealth. I'm Rachel. I assist Dr. Forsythe with his medical duties. Are you sick or injured?
Do you get a lot of patients in the vault?
No. The people of this vault are surprisingly healthy. If that's all, I have work to do.
Okay. She seems annoyed with me. Sorry for asking questions.
Dr. Forsythe and Rachel have plenty of medical supplies to get you stocked up.
Okay, I think that's it. Yeah, I think I've explored everywhere. So how many quests does that leave me with? I have the short stories. Was there anything else? No, I guess just the short stories quest. But Gwen. I want to speak with Gwen. I don't know where she is. I looked for her in her office. The overseer, and she wasn't there. We gotta wait until class is in session to give the stories, so... let's actually sit and wait. It's 1 a.m. No wonder class isn't in session. Well, class should be in session at like 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. That should be fine. Hopefully Gwen will be in the overseer's office too. Yeah, there we go. Class is in session. I did not do that.
Would you like to tell the students one of your stories now?
Yes, I'd love to.
What topics should I avoid?
Nothing with excessive violence. And I'm sure they'll have lots of questions.
Okay. Nothing with violence, huh? We'll see about that.
I'd be glad to.
Wonderful. The kids are so excited. Children! Children, listen up! We have a guest today who is going to tell us stories about the Commonwealth.
Did you ever fight a Deathclaw?
I did, yes. I did with nothing more than a pistol and 3 bullets. One of the Minutemen helped me kill one once. That's not true. I don't think they helped me. I'm pretty sure I did it alone. Just using a power armor suit.
Can I go now?
How do you know about Deathclaws?
I hear stuff. Gran heard something about them from a Commonwealth guy.
Deathclaws are very dangerous. Huh, it was a tough fight.
How did you beat it?
I can't seem to actually mention how I fought it. Well, I guess we just start from the beginning.
A group of raiders had my friend Preston trapped.
But you rescued him, right?
We were all scared. More raiders showed up. Preston said I should use the power armor.
Boy, I'd love to find some power armor.
I wasn't ready when the Deathclaw crawled out. Good thing I had that power armor.
That sounds scary.
I was hurt pretty badly. But Preston and I finally killed it.
Wow. Thank you so much for that story. Children, say thank you.
Thank you.
And we have a thank you gift for you. Here.
Grognak the Barbarian. Critical hits with unarmed and melee attacks permanently do plus 5% damage. Useless to me, unfortunately. Alright, you want any more stories? I'd love to give some more.
Bet you wish he took the tour now.
No. I think I've got a hang of this place. Thanks, Austin.
Hey, Katie.
Oh, you're that new traveler. You must have had so many adventures out in the Commonwealth.
Thanks again for bringing Ashes back.
No problem.
Gran says I'm a bottomless pit when it comes to food.
Okay, yeah. I guess that's
walking, it. Keep walking, outsider. Just because you wear a vault suit doesn't mean you're one of us.
Holt still doesn't want to talk to us, right?
Holt.
If you need something, ask Alexis.
Nope.
I can't make heads or tails of this sort.
Okay, so I don't actually have any other quests for this place, but I do have other things that I could potentially do. Like, I'm thinking about bringing Addictol back to help Tina's daughter. Tina's brother. See if I can do anything with that. I want to speak with Gwen, the overseer.
What I wouldn't give for some real time off.
She's in her office. Okay, let's go speak with her. Just saw her head poking through the window.
Have you been down to medical to see Dr. Forsythe yet? He told me he's very interested in meeting you.
Don't mind me, I'm just gonna sit in the overseer's chair.
Excuse me, overseer?
Take time to look around. You'll have the full run of the place.
Oh, she doesn't actually want to talk with me?
Feel free to make the most of the services we offer while you're here.
I guess that's basically it. I mean, it feels like there's a storyline between...
Look at you blending in with that vault suit.
Holt and... What's her name? Alexis? Holt and Alexis Combs? It feels like there's a storyline there where I can maybe help their relationship or something like that, but Holt doesn't want to talk to me, so I'm not sure what to do. Addictol could potentially be brought back to Tina's brother. Try talking with Alexis again.
Looking for something? I have more stuff than I know what to do with.
Nope, doesn't seem like it.
I'll think about it.
Most of this stuff?
And of course, we still need to plant the mute fruit. So you know what? I'm actually going to go do that. I'm going to go plant the fruit, and I'm also going to go buy some Addictol and see if I can give it to Tina's brother. Oh, I just got a quest to visit Austin in the clinic. So I've also got the Addictol. And also learned something about the mute fruit, but I'll talk about that in just a little bit.
You have to do something, Jacob.
I'm running the test as fast as I can, Priscilla. I can't treat Austin until I know what he's infected with.
Dr. Forsythe.
Not now, Bobby. And you, stranger, will have to wait your turn. We have an emergency here. Austin got bitten by a mole rat. Isn't that enough, Jacob? There can't be that many mole rat diseases or toxins.
Rachel is examining the mole rat. Hopefully she'll find something, but these aren't ordinary mole rats. Who knows what kind of diseases they are carrying? Because he's just a child, it's affecting him more severely.
Dr. Forsythe, please! I think I found something that might help Austin.
Bobby!
Hold on, Priscilla. What is it, Bobby?
Well, you know that door Austin found? He found it because of me. I keep my private things in there. He saw me get them.
You mean your chems?
Get to the point, Bobby. What did you find in that place?
It's like a whole extra vault in there, but half ruined and caved in.
Whoa.
There was this terminal there. So I started poking around in it. There were some notes and stuff about using mole rats to grow viruses. But they also said that they used them to make vaccines and treatments.
A secret vault? Good Lord, I've never heard of such a thing.
Bobby, you're a genius. A junky genius. There might be a cure for whatever Austin got from that mole rat somewhere in that place.
Well, this vault just got a lot more interesting. I was thinking the quests for this place seemed really lackluster, but yeah, a whole nother vault that I can explore full of, like, test mole rats.
Dr. Forsythe?
You there. How would you like to do Vault 81 a favor and possibly save my boy's life?
Of course.
I would be glad to help.
I was hoping I could count on you. Bobby here will show you where he keeps his secret stash. There is a chance that somewhere in there is a cure for Austin. If you find it, bring it to Dr. Forsythe. And for Austin's sake, please hurry.
Follow me.
careful of the mole rats down there. If they infected Austin, they could infect you as well.
Okay, well, I guess everything else can wait, because this is a lot more important.
Come on! Let's go.
I'm waiting. You're the one that got stuck on that corner of that thing. Here? Oh. Huh. Secret Vault 81. Alright, well, before we go there, let me see if I can give him the Addictol.
Hi, Bobby.
Apparently not. Doesn't even want to talk to me. Turning his back to me, alright. Well, I'll try to talk to him later. Maybe he's just not talkative because of the whole quest. Maybe I have to wait until the quest is over to have a normal conversation with him.
Bobby.
Yeah, he just does not care. Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm going to explore the secret Vault 81.